Wow, thank you. Well, West Virginia is one of the first tonight, and West Virginia has done it right. I want to be the first to share with you how optimistic I am about our future. Around the state today, West Virginia came together and made their voices heard to tell Washington that we can do better. And West Virginians voted to send a new voice to the Senate to speak for them that will always fight for our values. I go to the Senate with a mandate to make Washington work for West Virginia, to end this practice of picking winners and losers. Tonight, I want to be the first to extend my hand of cooperation to my friend, Senator Joe Manchin, and to the newly elected congressional delegation to join me in this fight to put West Virginia first again. For the first time in the history of West Virginia, we are sending a woman to the United States. And excited to be that United States Senator. It is impossible for me to convey the gratitude and how humbled I am by your confidence. I hope that I live up to your highest standards and that my service will serve as a role model for all the young women out there. Celia, this is for you. This is for you in our state, and an inspiration too that they can achieve great things. We were one of the first states to send a message to President Obama tonight that his policies were on the ballot today. And it can be heard loud and clear in the White House, I believe, that this president's agenda just isn't working for West Virginia. West Virginians want a better growing and a faster growing economy, better job opportunities, a strong middle class, and a certainty that our hard work still matters and still pays off. We also want an all-of-the-above energy policy that includes coal, West Virginia coal. We want the ability to choose our own doctor and to have the freedom to make our own health care decisions. And we want a national security policy that protects our families and protects our homeland. The first step towards creating a better future is making the Senate work for West Virginia again. I am looking forward to working with senators from all over the country, regardless of their party, on both sides of the aisle, that share the same optimism for our country that I do. Together, I hope we can reinstate respect for the institution of the United States Senate, a place where deliberation and debate are valued and all voices are heard. This election marks a true turning point in our state's history. It is the first time, we've heard that a couple times tonight, in nearly 60 years that we've sent a Republican to the United States Senate. And I believe with that our state's political climate has returned to a competitive two-party system that I hope will produce bipartisan solutions to our problems that will turn and make our state more prosperous and our communities stronger. Let me say thank you to a lot of people who have helped me make this night possible tonight. I would like to thank my family for their help, support, and if you know anything about us, you know we have a great sense of humor. And sense of humor over the course of this campaign. I would especially like to thank my husband, Charlie, because he has been there first for me to lend me moral support, and he's pushed me along the way. It has been a long but very fun journey and very, very memorable for all of us. To my campaign staff, who I wish I could name for you all here tonight, because I think we have the most wonderful team of talented, young, enthusiastic, bright, optimistic, and just the future is in their hands, campaign staff and volunteers. Let me be the first to thank all of you for your hard work and your tireless efforts over the last 2 years. You've made quite a difference in this state. Most of all, to my fellow West Virginians, wow. The responsibility that comes with serving you in the United States Senate will always be first in my mind. And I promise I will fight every day to make sure that your voices are heard. Thank you so much.